I've just arrived to my hotel in Manila and I'm not gonna lie, I'm like actually exhausted. I've arrived at Terminal 4, Singapore Airport. And I'm flying with JetStar today. I've never flown with JetStar. I've not heard great things, not gonna lie. So we'll see how this goes. You'll get my honest review. All of you, drinking till the sun comes up. Better feeling like I need you. This is the International Food Hall at Terminal 4. I don't know what I fancy, but I need to eat really. So I'm at my gate. I always forget every time I come to Singapore Airport how modern it is. Like every seat you sit in, there's a plug socket next to the seat. It's so crazy. And then like also they've got nap rooms and stuff like that, which I wish they had that last year in Abu Dhabi when we landed there, because we needed to nap so badly and there was just nowhere to nap. There's so many like comfy spaces here. There's a nap room, there's Wi-Fi, there's plug sockets everywhere. There's loads of places to eat and drink. It's just such a nice airport. So yeah, feeling good. I had some ramen for lunch as I showed. And this flight should take about 3.5 hours. So I'm very excited to land in Manila. And I'm a bit nervous about what JetStar's gonna be like, but yeah, we'll see. So I thought I'd give a review of JetStar and I was really impressed. It was 30 minutes delayed, but that's not bad at all really. And the leg room was surprisingly good. I'm 5'11 nearly and like I had room. And then I booked the, I always book the seat at the back of the plane, and I had a whole row to myself, which was even more amazing. Like, why does that always happen to me? It's like the luckiest thing ever. But yeah, really smooth flight. Actually there was a bit of turbulence, but nothing crazy. And yeah, landed in Manila. And overall, like, I would fly with JetStar again. I was pleasantly surprised. Finally got to the hotel and I'm really impressed. Like, it's such a cute room. So we're gonna do a little room tour. It's currently 10:36 at night. I'm absolutely, as I've said like 10 times, I'm getting straight into that bed, basically. So yeah, I'm gonna update you probably tomorrow, but let's do a quick room tour. So it's super clean, which is just like the best thing about any place I stay. Like if it's clean, then it's like a 10 out of 10 for me. This is the bed. I've got such a nice view. I'm gonna try and take a video when the lights are off because it's nighttime at the minute, but I'm on like a high floor, so that's really cool. Got a flat screen TV, and then over here I've got a little sink, a safe and a mini fridge, kettle. It's just like so nicely done. I'm impressed, and it was so cheap. Well, it was like £25 per night. Like, that is so cheap. And this is the bathroom. So I've got my private ensuite. I, for some reason, chose to wear this big jumper on the plane, and I actually, like, it was cold on the plane, but like when I was going to the airport I was so hot, so I took it off and I was like, no, it's fine, like I'll be so cold on the plane. And then I get to Manila and I'm like taking it straight off, like it's so hot. But yeah, won't choose to wear a jumper again when I go to the islands. Or actually, I will wear a jumper when I go to Japan because it's going to be spring there, so it will be acceptable. Anyways, good night, guys. Here's the morning view from my room. I did not expect to have such a cool city view, to be honest. So I was very impressed. It's about 1 o'clock and I'm gonna go find some lunch. I'm gonna try and get my nails done before I head off to the islands as well. But yeah, I'm like nervous and excited to get out and see Manila in the daytime, because obviously I arrived last night and it was dark, so I couldn't really see anything. So yeah, let's go find some lunch. I'm going to Century Mall and I've actually like had the aircon turned off all night because I was really cold, and it feels so weird to be in Asia and feel cold. And then I also turned the aircon off this morning as well, so maybe it's not going to be as hot here as I expected it to be. But yeah, just a plain little black outfit today, nothing special. Gonna go get lunch, get my nails done, and then come back and finish some work before I head off. I've got a week off next week, so yeah, lots to finish today. I'm just walking to Century Mall, Century City Mall. Interesting walk, not gonna lie. Quite a lot of homeless people, which I wasn't really expecting in this area because it's supposed to be like a tourist area. So yeah, it kind of shows you like the contrast. I just got confused because I got onto an escalator that doesn't work, but it said it was an automatic escalator and it didn't start moving. It's a very interesting experience so far, but my goal is to try and get some food.
There's a cinema on the top floor. Oh no, straight ahead. Some sort of art gallery down there as well. The lights are cute. Let's go down. I don't know whether to get food first. I probably will get food first, actually.
Okay, don't judge me for getting Burger King. I'm gonna explain myself when I get back to the room, because I had a really cringe, embarrassing experience. So then I just like ran to Burger King because I'm such a Westerner. So yeah, I'm sorry, I've let you all down. Okay, this is future Louisa coming back to explain the lunch situation. So I went to like a Filipino restaurant. In England, when you go to a restaurant, they'll like show you to a table, or at least tell you like, you know, sit down, we'll come over, or like order at the front. Cause like you can either have people like bring you the menu or you just go up and order, but you get told. So I'm like standing at the door and like everyone's kind of ignoring me. So I was kind of stood there like waiting for instruction because I didn't know whether to sit down like automatically or if that was like rude. So I just stood there for a bit, and then I was like, someone walked past me, like a staff member. So I was like, oh, can I sit down? And he kind of, I don't think he understood me, but he was just like, yeah. And then I was like, okay. So I sat down and I just sat there and I was looking around like, this is so awkward. Like, what do I do? Like, are they gonna bring me a menu? Like, how do I order? There's no like QR code on the table. And then I went up to one of the waitresses. I was literally just being ignored. And I was like, sorry, like, do I order at the, like, what? How do I order? And she's like, oh, order at the front. And then at that point, I went up to the front and I just stood there for ages. There was some people being served and I was like, okay, this is so awkward. Like, I felt so embarrassed. And then in the corner of my eye, I saw a Burger King and I was like, I don't know what, just something kicked in. I was like, just leave, like this has been too humiliating. Like everyone's looking at you, you're such a foreigner, like you don't know what you're doing, just leave. So I just walked out, I walked straight into Burger King. So like, I'm easing into it, it will happen, but like, it's my first day, I was overwhelmed, okay? So that's why, that's the reason for the Burger King. I tried, I really did. Just had a full body massage and I feel like so content, the most content I've felt for a while.